industrial design is flourishing. I began noticing 20 years ago at the University of the Earth, I began noticing how my industrial design majors had very supple minds, very dynamic minds, more intellectual, I felt, than the putative intellectuals who were academics in the Ivy League. That is, they were not the prisoners of ideology or kinks, but their industrial design field trains them to be looking at society with a very clear eye. Okay. And in fact, they're looking at the commercial world with a very clear eye because they're designing for it. But I felt that they seemed to be in tune, with the way culture was moving and the sort of deep rhythms, invisible rhythms of the development of culture. I also always felt that in the last 15-20 years that the animation majors are also very close to how culture is moving. So the animators seem to be very alive, very observant. It's very satiric, often these quirky and penetrating minds. But one has the sense of the field of painting losing that kind of relationship to the larger world. The painters do not seem to be as aware of things happening in the larger world. And of course, photography, great art form, has been in terrible crisis because of all kinds of technical developments with the arrival of digital. So I've been hearing mournful lamentations going on for years from my photography majors about the all kinds of companies not even making film anymore, the kinds of style of digital color and the kind of garishness of digital photography that they're all becoming kind of used to, our eyes are coming used to. But the one of the problems in terms of the visual environment for young people is that they have very few opportunities now to see great images. Okay. I was raised at a time when newspapers were powerful, and especially in the weekly magazines, were very powerful and published gorgeous pictures, beautiful in both black and white and color, wonderful composition, really quality photography. That's how I was raised. Now, by the way, just this afternoon came the news. Okay, Newsweek. Okay, is now over. Okay, as a magazine, it's going to go totally to an online format. That was announced this afternoon, by Tina Brown, and that to me is very sad because it's part of how the web has made newspaper publishing and news gathering, news transmission in general, it's just totally supplanted. I haven't had a student who actually picks up a newspaper in years. I subscribe to newspapers, and the lover of newspapers. I belong to once my generation goes, once the baby boomers sort of topple into the great ravine of the beyond, I think newspapers are going with us, because none of my students, have the slightest interest in picking up a newspaper. It's like it is completely, it's another world, to them. It's Time Magazine, Life Magazine, Look Magazine, even today, you can find in flea markets, copies of Life Magazine, you can pick them up, and they're incredible quality photography, So what's happening here, this is the problem. I think that if Newsweek and Time Time is probably failing equally, it's because they did not realize that if now people don't want to wait a week to get the news that they can get instantly from the web, then didn't they realize in a whole other area that the web cannot supply as well, and that is great visuals. Okay? And I think those magazines should have been going toward the visuals to be supplying people what they were, what they're missing. Because online images are, they're wonderful, they're bright, but they lack subtlety, they lack depth,